John Thomson effect. When a compressed gas is allowed to expand into a low pressure region or vacuum under adiabatic conditions, a lowering of temperature is usually observed. This is known as Joule Thomson effect. Almost all gases undergo Joule Thomson cooling effect at ordinary temperatures. Only hydrogen and helium shows Joule Thomson heating effect. So the major point over here, if you say, the first thing we need to remember is expansion of the gas, expansion of compressed gas under adiabatic conditions. What is adiabatic conditions? Is adiabatic conditions, there is no exchange of heat energy, between system and surroundings. So when your system is isolated completely from the surrounding, and the system alone is undergoing the changes in its temperature, study of change in the temperature due to the expansion of gas under adiabatic conditions is what Joule Thomson effect is. So when you talk about this particular one, let us see first one. If a gas is there, this is for anything other than hydrogen and helium at ordinary conditions of temperature. If I take the gas under very high pressure, so that the gas is present at under very high pressure, let us imagine more pressure is being applied on the gas molecules. If I am moving the gas molecule from high pressure region to a vacuum, let us say this is a vacuum which is at low pressure, correspondingly this becomes the low pressure region automatically. Now there is some gases are allowed to move through this particular one. Let us imagine you have the molecule over here. There is a molecule which has approached here, which is ready to leave this particular container, And this particular gas molecule is being attracted by the molecules from the behind. If I say the molecule is under the attractions by the molecules which are present behind it, since it is a real gas, it should be under the interaction with all other neighboring molecules surrounding it. So you can see the molecules which are behind are pulling the molecules inward. Now the molecule is not able to go freely by itself and leave the container from high pressure region and move into a container of low pressure region by itself. It is not free to do. It is under the influence of the molecules, the neighboring molecules, which are causing an inward pull from behind. Now, what does this molecule has to do is, this molecule has to break all the intermolecular forces. It has to break the attractive forces, and the molecule has to move. Molecule should overcome all the intermolecular forces. Overcome the intermolecular forces by utilizing its own energy to break the intermolecular forces. It is utilizing its own energy to break the intermolecular forces. At the expense of its own energy, it is overcoming the intermolecular forces and entering into this particular container, which is of low pressure region. Now, if a molecule reaches here, the molecule now will have energy which is left out with less kinetic energy. This will come with less kinetic energy. Same way, many molecules, every molecule comes out with decreased kinetic energy. The average kinetic energy of the system decreases. which is proportional to the temperature according to kinetic molecular theory, will also have an influence on temperature, will also show the decrease in the temperature. This is the reason when a gas undergoes an expansion from high pressure region to low pressure region is observed to have cooling effect. And this phenomena is called as Joule-Thomson effect.